Greetings. In this lesson, I'm going to demonstrate how to do the forward and backward pass to determine the estimated duration of the project. So here we have exercise 9, the air control company project. And the first thing you should do when you look at a diagram like this is review what's on the legend. And the legend contains early start, early finish, late start, late finish, duration, slack, and the ID. Right now, all we have is the ID and the duration. We'll be doing the forward and backward pass to get the early start and the late finish information. So to begin this exercise, we start with an early start of 0. Now, I don't want to argue about this. Some people want to get into existential questions about how can an early start be a 0. But just to do the methodology, the uses technique, we always start with 0. Just accept that. It'll make life a lot easier. So now we simply add and move, do what the text calls the forward pass. And so the earliest at activity A, if it takes 2 days, it will be done on the second day. That's the earliest it can be done. Then B can start once A is done. So can C, so can D, and so can E. The earliest start is the early finish for the preceding activity. Now we simply add the early start to the duration. 2 and 10 is 12, 2 and 13, 15, 2 and 18 is 20. Okay. Now we move to the next activity that we can look at, and that's F. And F is a merge activity, which means there's more than one activity that has to be completed before F can start. And this is where you need to keep in mind choosing the larger number. So we have two early finishes, 12 and 15. That didn't come out too well, so I'll correct that. And we choose the larger number, which is 15. Because F can't start until both C and D are completed. C's done in the 12th, but D's not to the 15th, so F has to wait until D's done. The earliest it can start then is 15. 15 and 15 is 30. And now we have another merge. G can't start until both B and F are done. Earliest B is done is the 17. The earliest F is done is 30. Again, we choose the larger number. 30, 30 and 10 is 40. And then finally, we have the last activity is also a merge activity. H can't start until both G and E are done. The earliest G is done is 40. The earliest E is done is 20. We choose the larger number, 40. 40 and 5 is 45. And we would now say that the earliest time this project could be completed is in 45 days, assuming days is the time unit that we're using. Now the late finish, we go backwards, and this time we subtract, and instead of choosing the larger number, we choose the smallest number when we're forced to make a choice. So the latest H can finish without delaying the project, obviously, is 45. 46 would mean it's a day late. So the late finish and the early finish for the last activity are always the same. We subtract 5 from 45, and the late start for H is 40. Again, the late start and the late finish is the latest this activity can start without delaying the project. The latest this activity can finish without delaying the project. So now we move back, and we simply transfer the late start to the late finish of the preceding activity. 40, 10 minus 40 is 30. 30 into here is 15. 15 minus 30 is 15. We go down here, we can take care of E. 40, 18 minus 40 is, you gotta remember your math, 22. Okay, now we can begin to see there's a difference here. This is a non-critical activity. We look up at B. The latest finish for B without delaying G is 30. 15 minus 30 is 15. Then these two activities off the merge activity, both 15 and 15. You got to follow the arrows backwards. 13 minus 15 is 2. 10 minus 15 is 5. And then we've got a bunch of arrows out of activity A. We got a late start of 22, a late start of 2, a late start of 5, and a late start of 15. We choose the smaller number, 2. 2 minus 2 is obviously 0. And when you have that, you know you're in good shape. And now we subtract to determine the slack. How much an activity can be delayed without delaying the project? We subtract the early start from the late start and the early finish from the late finish. On these problems, they'll be identical because there's no lags. We'll talk about lags and I think the third problem. But for now, we do both and they should be identical. So we go up here, subtract 2 from 22, it's 20. So what this means is that activity E can be delayed, the start of activity E can be delayed up to 20 days without delaying the project. And that makes sense if you look that activity E has an early start of 2 and a late start of 22. The difference between that is 20, so it has quite a bit of slack. And lo and behold, when we subtract the 2 early finish and late finish, we get the identical 20. Here we have zeros, which means a delay in activity D will delay the project. This is an indication that activity D is on the critical path. Then we have 3, and 2 from 15 is 13. And then we go here, subtract those two, and we got zeros. Zeros up here, and then the last activity naturally has zeros. And then we trace the critical path, follow the zeros in the slack. In this case, we have one critical path. I like to highlight it, make it stick out. And so A, D, F, G, H is the critical path. A delay in the duration, the estimated duration of any one of these five activities will delay the project. If activity D takes 15 days instead of 13 days, it will add 2 days to the duration of the project. If, however, activity B, instead of taking 15 days, end up taking 20 days, it would not delay the duration of the project, or the completion of the project, I should say, because it has a slack of 13. Now, the one other thing that we talk about is assessing the sensitivity of the network. And that's the likelihood that the original critical path will change once you start the project. And that's a function of two things. One, the number of critical paths, and two, how much slack the non-critical activities have. Here we only have one critical path, which suggests it's not very sensitive, but we do have one activity, C, that only has 3 days of slack. The other activities have quite a bit of slack, B and E. So you would say that this is moderately sensitive. And our only concern is that if C is delayed, it could become critical. So remember, add and choose the larger number going forward. When you go back, subtract and choose the smaller number.